Hey guys, welcome to Clear and Crisp Coding. Today we will be discussing the solution of Code Forces round 651 div 2 problem C, the number game. This was a really interesting problem and I liked it a lot. It was basically based on the math and you have to do some observations. So the problem statement is here. You can read the problem, and in simple terms, if I explain you without missing any important point, then the problem is something like this. We would be given some number n, and this number would be the starting point. We would be starting at this point and playing a game, and the game would be played between two players, Ashish Group and Fast Finger. Let's call them the first player and the second player for simplicity. And the first player would start the first as it is given here, and the game goes something like this. The first player can do any of these two operations. He can divide the number, given number, by any of its odd divisors. This point is really important. It should be odd divisors which are greater than 1. Or he can subtract 1 from n if n is greater than 1. This is also a really important point, that any of these two operation can only be done if the number is greater than 1. If the number is greater than 1, then none of the operation can be done, so nothing would be done. And it is given that the game will terminate when a player is not able to make a move. That means any of these two operations are not applicable, which will happen when the number has reached 1. Because if it is greater than 1, we can apply any of these operations. So now here it is given some sample test case. So before going on these, let's have some more clarity on the question and how would the solution look like. So basically, let's consider any n. So n is basically any natural number, as it is given the n starts from 1 to 10 to the power 9. So any natural number can be represented as a multiplication of the prime factors of its prime factor, like 2 to the power x times 3 to the power y times 4 to the power z times 4, it would be 5, because 4 is not a prime, and then 7 to the power t, and then so on. So this n number can be represented as this, the multiplication of some power of its prime. So basically here, if we see that in the question it is given in the first operation, what we can do with n? We can divide n by any of its odd divisor greater than 1. So what are the odd divisors? So if we look carefully, for any number n, the odd divisors are these. Other than these two, which covers all these even powers, all the other prime factors are odd. So we can divide n with any of these prime factor or their combination. It could be any of it. We can divide individually or their combination, but we cannot divide n with its even prime factor as given in the first operation. And in the second operation, we can just directly subtract n. Subtract 1 from n if n is greater than 1. Okay. So now let's see what would be the optimal winning strategy by knowing this, that a number can be represented like this. So first of all, we would be getting the starting number. So let's suppose the given number to us is 12. Okay, so if we see this form of representation of 12, it would be 2 to the power 2 into 3 to the power 1, 2 to the power 2 is 4, 4 into 2 is 3. So here it is. We are representing this number into this form. Now we basically have to observe one thing very carefully. So, and the one point given here is also that the number can be divided, the divisor of a number is included itself. So if we get an odd number, suppose n equal to 13 somewhere, then one of its divisor is 13 itself, and we can divide it by 13 according to this line. So 13 by 13 would be equal to 1. And the person who would be doing this would be the winner. So now let's just make a note of it here. So if initially n is odd, then the person whose turn is the winner. Okay, so basically this is the main point. So now let's see, it is given that Ashish Group would move first. So if initially itself the number is odd, then we don't need to make any observation and we can just return that the winner is Ashish Group. So if n is odd, then we can just return like this. So now let's get back to this question. Here it is given 12. So initially n is not odd in this case, so we cannot directly say that the winner would be definitely Ashish Group. So we have to do some processing here. Now let me just clear this and we would be discussing how would that processing be going on. So 12 is 2 to the power 2 into 3. So now what can Ashish do? He is the first player. He has two operation. Either he choose a positive divisor of this number and then divide this by this number by it, or he can just subtract 1. So basically this operation is really harmful. So like if we see here, the number is even, and if we subtract 1 from an even number, what would this number become? This number would become an odd number, and as it is given that odd number and odd number has a divisor 11, so 11 by 11 would directly be 1. So if we have even number and we subtract 1 from it, then this number would definitely be odd, and an odd number can be divided by itself as it is a divisor of him, and the answer would be 1, then the person would lose. So doing this operation when currently you have an even number is not acceptable, so we won't be doing this unless it is compulsory for us that we have to do this operation. Okay, so now this is clear. At this point, if we perform this operation, that means that we lost. So what other operation can we do? We can choose any other positive divisors and divide it. So this is a positive divisor and then we divide it with it. So 12 by 3 equals to 2 to the power 2 into 3 upon 3. This 3 cancels, so it remains as 4, which is 2 to the power 2. Now the second person's turn is there. So he has an even number 4, but here if we see here also, these same case are applicable, because here we had even number initially and it was first person's turn. Now it's second person's turn and we have an even number. So this condition is applicable that if we subtract 1, then we lost the game. And if we divide it with a positive divisor, then there can be some chance that in the future we can win. But if we are compulsory that we don't have any positive divisor and we have to divide by minus 1 and we have to subtract by minus 1, then definitely it means that we have lost the game. So here if you can see, it does not have any positive divisor. So the second person has only one option to just reduce it by 1, then it would become 3, and then the third person would have 3 to the power 1, it has a positive divisor, so 3 by 3 it would be 1, and this person would, second person would not able to make any move as this number has reached 1. So here is the main observation, that if we have any even number and we are forced to do this operation, then we lose. Okay, so if we have an even number and we are forced to just do this operation, then we lose. Okay, so now this one is clear. So now let's move on to another observation, which would be that, so if a number is 2 to the power x, 3 to the power y, 4 to the power z, 5 to the power z. Now what is to be done? If suppose there is a situation that it has just, suppose let's consider example of 10 itself. So 10 can be represented as 2 into 5. Okay, 10 is 2 into 5. So the first person's turn is currently, so 10 is even, so the same condition which we discussed earlier, that if we did this operation then we lose. So we have only operation this that we can do to survive. So we did this and then this would become 2. 10 by 5 is 2. And this here also it's 2. Now it's second person turn. This is 2. So he has only, and it is does not having any positive divisors. So the only option available to this person is to do this operation. But if we observe carefully that after doing this operation, this has turned to 1. So now the first person does not have any option to do and he lost. So what is a great observation here? So we have discussed two cases of 10 and 12. In the 12, the first person had an even initially. So he did this operation and he gave 4 to the second person. The 4 person did not have any positive divisor, so he was forced to do this second operation by reducing this by 1 and lost. Whereas in this case, the first person again had an even number, so he cannot perform the second operation. So he divided it with the available positive divisor and gave 2 to the second person. But here second person did not have any other positive divisor, so he reduced it by 1. But here also, after doing this operation, he is able to win. So this is a really important case. So if the number left is 2 after removing all the positive divisors, then the person with this condition would win. So basically now let me just summarize all this to make this really clear. That so we have basically now two cases. So case number 1, when the power of 2 is 1, that means something like this: the 10 is represented 2 to the power 1, 5 to the power 1. And case number 2, when power of 2 is greater than 1, which is this case, power of the 2 is greater than 1. So in this case, if you observe carefully, in this case 1, when the power of 2 is 1, we are losing here, because after removing all these odd powers, what would be left is just 2, and when we did 2 minus 1, we had no option to move. Whereas in this, if we have just greater than 1 power of 2, when we remove this 3, what would we have? We had this left, which had 2 to the power 2, and when it is reduced by 1, it is not equal to 1. It is equal to 3, which is an odd number, and then second person and the first person won the game. So in this case, when that power of 2 is 1, the first person has to have, in this case, the first person cannot win over here. If we are able to see that when he removed this, the left one was this, and in this case, when the power of 2 is greater than 1, then definitely the first person would win. So this case is clear: when the power of 2 is greater than 1, the first person would always win. So in the first move, always only, he would remove all the positive powers, and then he would give some 2 to the power number to the second person, and the second person had this, due to this constraint that 4 minus 1 is odd, he would not want to do this, but there would be no other positive divisors left because it would be removed in this step. So he only have to reduce it by 1, and after reducing, the first person can divide just by 3 and get 1 and win the game. But so this case is now clear. So now let's focus on this case when the power of 2 is exactly 1. So in this case, is there some way that the first person can win the game? Yes, there is one very, very tricky way which we have to do. So suppose that power of 2 is 1 in some number, and there are 3 and 5. Suppose this is a number, this is 30, I think. Yes, it's 30. So in this case, if we see, how can the first person win the game? So here it is the first person's turn. Now suppose he just gave one odd divisor and this 2 to the power 1 to the second person. Then the second person would get 2 to the power 1 into 3. And now here is the great observation. Now the second person has two options: either to divide by 3, which is the only positive divisor left, because we are giving only 1. If the power of 2 is 1, then we are giving only 1 divisor. Or the second operation is reduced by 1. So since this number is even, as it is multiplied by an even number, so that doing the second operation would definitely make this person lose, and dividing by 3 again would give the person back only this number. That means when we divide this by 3, we would be definitely getting 2, and then the first person can just remove 1 using this second operation and win the game, because the second person would get 1 and none of the operation can be performed. So basically, for this case, if we generalize, if we have 2 to the power 1 and some, suppose x to the power a, y to the power b, z to the power c. So if a plus b plus c is greater than 1, that means there is at least 2 greater. If we write it more clearly, a plus b plus c should be greater than or equal to 2. Then we can just pass 2 and 1 amongst all of these. Like here we had 3 to the power 1 and 5 to the power 1, we passed 3 to the power 1. So here also, if we pass just any one of them, then the second person has no option than returning us back 2, and after that we can just remove one to make it one and win the game. So this is the main important point. So we had basically two cases. In this case, we would say that if the 2 to the power is greater than 1, that means it is something like 2 to the power 4 into 3 to the power 1 into 5 to the power 1, then definitely the person winning would be the first one, as he can initially take all this power away or divide by dividing, and then the remaining would be this part, and the other person would have no option left rather than to perform in this operation, which would give us a odd number, and odd number we can just directly divide. Whereas in this case, we can just give the second person only one positive divisor, and then the second person had no option if we reduce it by one, because this is an even number currently, 2 into something is even, and if we reduce by one it becomes odd, and when the odd number is divided, then it is, and the first person can just directly divide by that odd number to get one. So the second person has only one option, which is to return back by dividing this x, and the first person then can easily win by subtracting it by 1 and giving back 1. So now let's get to the code. So these are the basically two cases which I am doing in the code also. So code wise, if we see, here is the code. So basically these are the base cases which I am handling, because I don't want to make the code more complex. So I just handled n equal to 1 and n equal to 2 here. Then for remaining part, if we see, I am first here counting the power of 2 in this n. So like if we see n equals to 2 to the power a into 3 to the power b into 5 to the power c into 7 to the power d. So these are all the prime factors. I am counting the power of n in of 2, 3, 5, 7. So initially here, I am just counting the power of 2. Here I am just counting the power of 2, and then and I am also initially taking value n and value variable equal to n, and then reducing this power. So now after this point we will have this count of the power of 2, which would be a here in the count of e variable, and the value would be reduced by n by 2 to the power a, as it is in the e step divided. So here basically in this step I am just counting this, what is the value of this a, and after that for the remaining part, here I am running a for loop from I equal to 3 to when I square is less than val and I plus equal to 2, because I just want odd values, and if sum of the value divides the remaining value, then I am just counting their power also. So like suppose the value here was 12 and 3 divides 12, so I am just counting the number of time it can be divided, and just this power value I am counting. So basically not only power, I am just getting this sum of this all a b c d, because here we have discussed that a plus b plus c should be greater than 2. So I am just cumulatively counting a plus b plus c plus d here. And now here is a base case, because in this method, if you have observed that if the value is a prime number, then it would stay there only and it would not be counted. So if it is odd, I am just also counting that. Then here are the two cases we discussed. So if the power of 2 is 1, if the power of 2 is 1, then the count of is just greater than 2, then we are marking OK as 1. This O1 means that the first person would win. Then if the count of E equal to 1 and this count is greater than 0. So if the case is this, and this sum of the odd divisors is greater than equal to 2, then OK is 1. That means the first person will win. Else, if the power is, so if the power is not equal to 1, that means basically I'm just handling the even part, even cases here. So if the power is not 1, then it would be something greater than 1, like 2 to the power 2, 2 to the power 4. Then in that case, we have discussed that if there is at least one divisor here, then we can win by just first of all removing all these divisor by dividing and giving this even number to the second person, and he would be returning us this even number minus 1, and we would be winning the game. And based on this condition, and also this is one important point, that I am checking that if n was initially odd, that means the given number was always already odd, then the answer would definitely be this, and if any of these two cases happen, then also the answer would be first, otherwise the answer would be second. So this is the main approach. This basically problem includes factorization. We have to find all these power, and based on these two conditions, if 2 to the power a equal to 1, then we have to proceed this way. If a is not equal to 1, then we have to proceed this way, and by this we can able to get the answer. So I hope I was able to understand. If you had any doubt, please let me know. I will definitely help you and try to make you understand. And I do subscribe to the channel. I will be posting more material like this. I regularly participate in the contests. So thank you for watching, guys. Thank you.